Okay, I'm just finishing up some radio programming details, and the Orion 2 is now ready for its first test flight. Let me show you some of the build details on how I rigged out the fuselage and installed the wing servos. So here's the install for the flap servo on the left wing. I have the servo frame pushed fairly far forward in the pocket. I can just barely reach that screw here because I want to have the servo horn here on the thicker part of the wing, and just barely clears the servo cover. And I CA'd with black CA the frame in. Definitely use epoxy, like a JB weld or some high strength epoxy, not 5 minute. With the sub trims, I have the servo arm cant a little towards the leading edge. So as it pushes back, remember it pushes back for down flap, we'll have plenty of throw and travel. And I'm getting about 70 to 75 degrees down flap, which definitely does the trick. I'm using the Thomas hardware here and glued with black CA into a carbon push rod. So here's the drive coming out of the top of the wing surface here, and using the Thomas Lewis Studios hardware, of course. I also used his horns. I did have to cut off about half the thread on the horns. So, you know, if you threaded his down all the way, they would pierce the bottom of the surface. So that's something you have to look out for. But it had nice geometry here. It's nice and tight. The hardest part was just judging on how far to cut the slot here. So we have, you know, no air gap here, but we also don't have any binding when the surface goes through for aileron control and landing flaps. So here's the aileron servo install, and notice that I'm not using the frame. The frame actually stuck up because the wing is so thin out here. I just couldn't get it to fit in without some major modifications and grinding, and probably would have lost the bearing end of that as well. So I just went a little bit old school. I wrapped the servo in Kapton tape like I did with the rudder and elevator servos in the fuselage, and it's glued in with the E6000 clear adhesive here, which bonds really well to, you know, sanded carbon. So I'm not worried about this servo pulling loose. You can see the horn is fairly short here because I want resolution and I want stiffness. Again, using the Thomas Studios hardware glued into the carbon rod. So here's the clevis exiting the top of the wing skin and connecting into the horn. This horn also had to be trimmed so it didn't poke through the bottom surface. So for canopy latches, I use an old trick, and this is just using carbon rods. You could use some steel wire as well. Sticks that about half an inch here, and then using a patch of glass or carbon to firmly glue them into the canopy surface here. So this spring effect latches underneath the fuselage, and then the canopy slides in place and then latches in the back as well. Now to get power to the wings, I'm using a standard 6-pin multiplex connector. It's countersunk into the fuselage. Two little holes on the side of it are to get CA around the connector because the material at the wing root is pretty thin. There's not much gluing surface, so any extra glue you can get in there will keep the connector from punching through. There's my CG marks. So here's the power for the right wing, and it's the female end of a 6-pin multiplex connector. And I have plenty of strain relief. There's three layers of strain relief on here, so this will take a lot of abuse. So I also have the polarities marked, so I have both minuses on one end, both positives on the other end, and then the top two pins are for flap and aileron. There's really nothing to do in the tail except to put the bolts in to hold the elevator on, attach the pushrod wire into the horn, which is already installed, and then slide the rudder in and engage its pushrod wire, which are automatically kept in place, and that's it for the tail. So here's the PNC firewall mounted in, and the screws are set with Loctite, of course. And I noticed this plane was cut with quite a bit of down thrust, but I fly my planes more CG neutral, so I don't want to have to trim the down thrust out. So I did adjust, I sanded back the cutout a little bit. So I set this plane up and set it at 0-0. So the decollage, zero decollage angle matches the firewall, and they're 90 degrees to each other. Setting up the spinner and the prop blades was pretty easy to do. I did remount the prop holes just a little bit because they were tight on the screws, also have an elastic band that keeps the blades folding back. I'm just using girls' hair bands right now. They tend to work pretty well, but I've got some thicker O-rings on order. Now for the radio programming, I'm using a basic 4 servo wing setup, and I'm actually just using a modified template from my Explorer 3.8. It's almost exactly the same plane and same sections. So you can see we're going to do a left turn here. You can see the inboard sections of the flap on the top follow the ailerons about 2-to-1 ratio. There's a right turn. Now, I don't have much differential programmed in. This is a shorter spanned airplane, and with a little bit of rudder mix, it's not going to need a whole lot of differential. So you can see the differential is just about zero. Differential changes with speed mode. So get my tuning videos if you want to learn how that differential works. Now for camber, this is basic cruise mode, so the wing is in section, even though in section means the wing does have a little bit of camber built in. So this is basically kind of like thermal 1, but here's my thermal mode 2. So I click that in. You can see the whole trailing edge droops together. So that's in section, thermal 2. And also I have side slider, so I can add even more camber if I want to over camber for really slowing the plane down and climbing in a tight thermal. So I have about 3 millimeters more, and I can adjust that in flight, and that mixes to the elevator 2, so the trim remains stable. Also have a speed mode, so that means we're going to get rid of that camber, go to speed mode, and the whole trailing edge goes up, which means the wing is going to have the least amount of camber, and this is for speed and dash. Back in thermal, back to cruise mode. So looking to the inboard wing route, here's camber again, here's cruise mode in section, here's thermal 2. Side slider added. Back to cruise. Let's go to reflex. There's reflex. Back to cruise. Reflex. Cruise. Even in reflex, I can add more reflex if I want even more, you know, down trim, you know, for more wind. So in all my flap modes, I do have the slider active, and I can change camber actively. And of course we have landing flaps available in all flight modes, except for launch. So I'm getting about 70 degrees of landing flaps, and that should be plenty. You notice I'm also not using any crow braking. If I find I need more braking power, I'll add in a little bit of crow, which means the ailerons will actually go up as the flaps go down. I also have an elevator to camber mix set up in all flight modes, so when I pull pitch, this is back stick, you can see the aileron's going down, so the whole trailing edge is changing, adding camber. This helps the elevator work more efficiently, and the wing work more efficiently as you're doing pitch maneuvers. I do have a fourth flight mode, and that's launch. So when I go into that flight mode, it puts the wing into reflex mode because we want a clean, fast wing, not a lifty wing. But that also, retrims the elevator. It changes my mixes. It turns the rudder mix off. And then it also arms my motor switch. So when I click the motor switch, which only is live in this flight mode, then the motor goes from 0 to 100% for climb out.